I think I've come up with it, Jim.
What is it, Barney?
A remote control unit.
Will it work?
Well, I hope so.
Well, so do I. Everything depends on it.
You want me to turn it on?
Yeah, turn it on.
Buenos dias.
What you been up to?
Hi.
Nice day.
What's shaking, baby? What's the good word?
Oh. Look who's here. Hey, how you been?
Long time no see. How's it going?
Say, my man, let's have some skin.
How you feeling?
Give me five.
Ain't it great to be alive?
How's the world been treating you?
Well, well.
What's the story?
So what's up?
Well, what do you know?
Howdy.
Hi there.
Say, what's cooking?
Hey, how are you? Hello!
The Adventures of Letterman. Finances. A very rich man is taking his money to the bank, the Piggy First National. Unbeknownst to him, our villain, the Spellbinder, is waiting by the night deposit box. Wait, what's that villain doing? He's changing the M in money to an H, turning money into honey.
Oh, my.
Now he's got liquid assets. He is stuck in the honey.
Where's Letterman? Can he stop this sticky financial crisis?
Look at his little fingers stuck in the honey.
Vaulting out of the night like a bouncing check he comes. Faster than a rolling O. Stronger than silent E.
Shh.
Able to leap capital T in a single bound. It's a word. It's a plan. It's Letterman.
I'm Letterman.
Help.
I'll save you.
Thank you.
This is a pain. Goodbye.
Taking B-A-L from the Piggy First National Bank, he turns honey into baloney.
Just what am I supposed to do with all this baloney?
Open a delicatessen?
Will the man open a delicatessen? Will the bank accept baloney? I know they accept bread.
Now, that's very simple to remember. You got it?
All for one.
Yeah, all for one and one for all, right? All right, let's go. Roll on! Action!
All for nothing, and nothing for
cut,
all.
Cut. No, wait a minute. Wait, Steve. Steve. The line is all for one.
I get it. I get it.
And one, Susie, will you hold up the cue card? All for one and one for all.
She doesn't
have
to show that.
You look at the cue card. Let's go.
I got it.
Room!
All for one and one for all.
Right.
For me, and nothing for you.
Cut. No. The line is all for one and one for all. Read the cue card. Listen to your line. All at the beginning, all at the end, all is at the end as well. Now, you got that?
All
right. Roll on.
Gotcha.
Yeah. Listen.
And all at the end for you.
Now look, Steve.
I know.
It's already past midnight.
It's late.
It's past midnight, and you have been fluffing that line all day.
All day.
Now the line is all for one and one for all. Steve, baby, look at me.
All.
That means that you are for everybody else. Now will you please remember we're going to do one more take, and that's all.
Okay, that's all.
Roll everything. All right. Action!
All for you and nothing for yourself!
I don't deserve this. I don't deserve this.
Julie, how you doing?
Hi, everybody.
How are you?
Like your dress?
Hi.
Is that how you greet your friends? Hi, hello?
Yeah, sure.
Hi.
That's dull.
Dull?
Yes.
What other way is there?
There's only one way.
What is it?
The best way.
What's that?
You slip him some skin.
A friend on the street, just slip him some skin. When he comes near you, all you gotta do is slip him some skin.
Slip him some skin.
He won't even have to ask. It don't make no sense to ask. Hold out your hand, stick out your chin. Slip him some skin, slip him some skin.
Remember, slip them that skin.
Who is it?
It's the plumber. I've come to fix the sink.
Who is it?
It's the plumber. I've come to fix the sink. It's the plumber. I've come to fix the sink.
Who is it?
It's the plumber. I've come to fix the sink.
the sink.
A gracious hello. This is your operator. Who is this? What do you mean? It's the plumber, and you've come to fix the sink. Speak up. I can't hear you.
Who can turn a can into a cane? Who can turn a pan into a pain? It's not too hard to see. It's silent E. Who can turn a cub into a cube? Who can turn a tub into a tube? It's elementary for silent E. He took a pin and turned it into a pine. He took a twin and turned him into twine. Who can turn a cap into a cape? Who can turn a tap into a tape? A little glove becomes a globe instantly. Sam stayed just the same. Who can turn a man into a mane? Who can turn a van into a vein? A little hug becomes huge instantly. Don't add W, don't add X, and don't add Y or Z. Just add silent E.
Hey, you look upset.
Well, so do I.
What's the matter?
Somebody stole my new book.
Well, hadn't you finished reading it?
Hey, I haven't even finished coloring it yet.
Oh, gee, that's too bad.
I'm sure you're right.
Look out.
Easy reader, that's my name.
Carmella, baby. And remember, from Easy, here's a reading tip. Alphabet soup will make you flip. Watch out. Take care now, right? Where's Sam Stanley? What's happening? I said, what you got for old Easy? Look at this man go. Rip open a ripe banana. Ow! Ha, ha, ha. Groovy, baby. You thought you were going to get me with that old silent E, didn't you? Rip and ripe. Ha, ha, ha. That's cool. I say, you got any more, Stanley? Yes. Well, whoop it on, man. Look out. Look out. Yippee, a yellow yo-yo. All those y sounds. Cool, Stanley. Baby, you all right. Give me one more. Just one more, and I'll be on Try Me Later. Oh, Stanley. Come on, now.
Easy, I've been looking all over for you.
Hey, see, JJ, everything's cool.
Listen, they just delivered this package for you.
Oh, I've been waiting for this, JJ. This is something I ordered special, man.
Yeah?
Yeah, baby. This is, wow, this is groovy. Wait till you see it. Wait till you see it. Look at
that. Oh, easy. Huh? That looks beautiful.
Yeah, you ready for that? Yeah, it sounds beautiful, too, baby.
What?
Oh, yeah. Genuine, 100% wool. Do not. Dry clean. Is that heavy? I say, is that heavy? Wash in lukewarm water, squeezing suds gently through the back.
Enter, exit, one way.
You'll be quiet and you sing it.
Clapping, toe-tapping, finger-snapping, make-it-happen sounds. New sounds, blue sounds, howdy-do sounds. I got old sounds, soul sounds, and jelly roll sounds. Sounds that are righteous, righteous, and out of sightious. And right now, folks, the biggest thing on the charts, the hit tune that sounds like now, now, that sounds like wow, that sounds like ow. Here is the short of the circus with I'm Just a Clown Who's Feeling Down. A clown who's feeling down. Yeah. Heavy, heavy,
heavy. I mean, out of sight.
How adorable.
How am I ever going to get any sleep?
Here's another riddle. Okay? Mm-hmm. What has 10 legs, mm-hmm. 10 legs, mm-hmm. and sings?
What has 10 legs and sings?
Okay, we give up.
What has 10 legs and sings?
Uh-huh. The short circus.
Oh, no.
Quick, run for your lives. It's the ugly bug.
The ugly bug?
Yeah, the ugly bug. He's headed here right now.
The ugly bug? Let's hide.
Yeah, quick.
Have no fear. The blue beetle is here. And I shall save you, poor little children, from that ugly bug. Do not panic. I have arrived.
The ugly bug!
You ever have one of those days?
Spider-Man, where are you coming from? Spider-Man, nobody knows who you are.
Today's episode, Spidey up against the wall. Your friendly neighborhood Spider-Man has decided to take the day off from his exhausting and frustrating war against crime and catch the baseball game. Little does Spidey realize that in this unlikely location, he will soon be up against the wall. A normal, happy high school student, until an incredible blunder during a chemistry experiment turned him into a wall. And now he's out to spoil everything, including Spidey's day off. It's the top of the sixth, two out and a man on, and Spidey is cheering his favorite player, Gumbo Braithwaite Idy.
Hey, no hitter in there, Tommy, baby. No hitter. Chuck it in there, babe. Spoon it up to him. Slip it to him. Slip in the pill, babe. Way to go. Ho-ho. Help over.
Suddenly, there's a routine fly ball.
I got it. No sweat.
Gumbo camps under it. No need to go to the wall for this one. But wait. The wall is coming to him. The ball goes over the wall for a cheap home run.
Now listen here, you. That's not funny. Says right here in the rule book that that's not funny.
Tough tamales, four eyes.
Oh yeah.
No one can stop the wall.
No one?
Well, if it isn't the wall crawling creep. Here's one wall you'll never crawl, you red and blue buffoon. He's so dumb, he's trying to eat a hot dog with no mouth.
That does it.
Now listen here, you. The rule book clearly states that no spectators or walls are allowed on the field of play. So I'm throwing you out of the ballpark and take that wall with you. Lucky I didn't slap him with a $50 fine. I can be pretty stupid when I want to be. Hubba hubba.
That's all the thanks you get, Spider-Man. They didn't even let you keep your scorecard.
Spider-Man,
Where are you coming from, Spider-Man? Nobody knows who you are.
Ch- ooh. Choo. 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 Chin.
Chin.
Ch. Ip.
Chip.
Ch. Imp.
Chimp.
Ch. Ill.
Chill.
Ch. Ick.
Chick.
Ch. In.
Chin.
Chet.
Chew.
Chow.
Cheese.
Choose.
Chair.
Chain.
Charm.
Child.
Children.
Cheat.
Juggle.
No, harp, harp.
Choke.
Jump.
Chicken.
Chipmunk.
Chimpanzee.
Chattanooga Choo Choo.
Charlie.
Cheater.
Champ.
One, two, chop, chop, chop.
Tried to teach his chimpanzee to cha-cha-cha, to give his chubby chum a chance to dance.
Cha-cha-cha.
But the chimp would rather munch,
cha-cha,
another bunch of lunch,
cha-cha,
and cha-cha-cha to cheat with Charlie's ants.
Cha-cha-cha.
There's a banana in your ear.
Pardon me?
There's a banana in your ear.
Pardon me?
There's a banana in your ear.
Pardon me?
There's a banana in your ear!
Sorry, I can't hear you. There's a banana in my ear.
I can't hear you. I've got a bonanza in my ear.
Cinderella!
Yes, wicked stepmother!
Cut that out.
Okay.
Bring me my brush.
Your brush?
Correct.
Right. I know where it is. Here is your brush.
Back to your broom. Cinderella!
Yes, wicked!
Bring me my bracelet.
Your bracelet.
That's right.
One bracelet.
Back to your...
I know, back to my broom.
Cinderella!
Yes, Wick?
Bring me my breakfast.
Your...
And be brisk about it.
Gotcha.
So?
Where shall I put it?
Well, where do you think, you country clot? On my lap!
Okay. Taxi!
I am cute.
Oh, that's nice. Someone thinks I'm cute. How about very?
Ah, I am cute, very. Who's the dummy writing this show? Now let's move that very around a little bit and get it right. I very am cute. That's it. That's wrong. I very am cute. The proper way to say it is I am very cute. Boy, to get a compliment around here, you really have to work for it.
Come here, go first. Go
what
first?
Letter are you?
I am the first.
Nobody knows.
I am the first.
We are the first.
You guys,
it's your turn.
Always.
Peace.
Special word, if is a word that helps me dream with if I imagine lots of things, no matter how strange those things may seem. Like, for instance, if Fargo North were Fargo South. If Zachary could fly. If falling down were falling up. Water made you dry. If Allison could run backwards, there she goes. If kids were 10 feet tall. If there were no such word as if, I'd have no fun at all. Of special word, if is a word that helps me dream with if I imagine lots of things, no matter how strange those things may seem. If you make a difference, I'm a lucky stiff to have a magnificent if. Not bad.
Read that message. It's very important.
Do not bother this giant person.
do not bother this giant person. Oh, excuse me, sir. I seem to be having trouble reading the...
What? Why? Do not bother this giant person. That's me.
Oh, do not bother this giant person.
You look like me. You look like me. We look alike. Looks like it. I like you. Likewise.
Take a dose. I like you. I like you. Like a farmer likes something growing. Like sailors like to go to sea. Like blowing, like everyone likes being free. I like you,
and I like you too.
Oh, now that was silly, but of course, so are you.
Hey, baby, what's happening? Did you catch that show last night on TV? What's the name of that rock group? It's right on the tip of my tongue. Anyway, those cats were really smoking. They were cool, you dig? Man, what a heavy show. Wow, it really blew my mind. But I got my head together. Hey, man, for a baby, you got a good head on your shoulders. Well, gotta split. Catch you later.
Hey, I'm starved. Let's stop for a snack, huh?
You mean snack?
No, that's what smoke comes out of, a smoked snack.
No, you mean stash.
No, that's what if you sit on it, you get up very fast.
Oh, you mean tack.
No, that's what a train runs on, a railroad tack.
No, you mean track.
Oh, that's a smart remark, you know, a wise track.
You mean crack.
You may be right.
Cracker Jack.
Lick a lolly, lick a lolly.
I bought a whole bunch of books at a junk store today. Some of them might be rare.
You can keep the rare ones. I like mine well done.
And now, it's time for a very short book. The Princess and the Pea. The Queen wanted to find out if this were a real princess. The Queen piled 20 mattresses on her bed. Under the bottom mattress, she placed a pea. That night, the princess went to bed. The next morning, that pea was flatter than a pancake. The end.
Turn on the electric company if I could find the switch.
A little dot, but it occupies a very special spot. If you should see a period, my friend, then you know a sentence just came to an end. Dance dot. Oh, oh baby. Ooh. Ah, make you feel so good.
The boy is sitting.
Of chair. Can a boy from a small chair in a big room find happiness as a top dog in a pet shop? As our story begins, the boy is sitting. The boy is wearing pants. The boy is bending over. The pants are splitting. Will the pants hold up? Will the boy hold up? Will the show hold up? And what about Naomi? For the answer to these and other questions,
did the bell ring?
Tune in tomorrow for Love of Chair.
I am talking. That's pleasant. I like a nice chit-chat now and again. I am not talking. I am not talking. If I am not talking, then whom am I listening to? There's nobody else in the room, so I must be talking. I'm talking!
remarks can be very confusing. And that is why I have invented a way by which we can hear punctuation marks as well as see them. And here's how it works. A period sounds like this. An exclamation point is a straight line with a period underneath. And here is a comma. Quotation marks are two commas. Or if you happen to be left-handed. Question mark is rather difficult. I have a book here, and I'm going to read a chapter from a story to you so you can hear how it sounds when this system is being used. I have marked the chapter so that I can find it easy. It's right here in the beginning of the book, and I should, it is to save time that I have marked it. Here it is. Here it is on page 9. Page 6. Once upon a time, a prince was riding through the woods. Suddenly, he saw a terrible dragon. What is this? Asked the prince. Arrgh! Said the dragon. Those are fighting words, said the prince. Take that, and that, and that, and that, said the prince. So the dragon took that, and that, and that, and that. And that was the end of the dragon. And this is the end of this.
You Fargo North?
I might be. Who are you?
I don't have time for that. Listen, I'm in trouble. I need your help.
What brings you to me?
Well, I was in the neighborhood buying a horse. Now, can you make any sense of this?
Let's see. Where did you get this?
Well, it came with a horse.
Uh-huh.
Supposed to make the horse go, but it's not working.
I see. Host Silver High. Very
yes.
Strange. Let's just put this in the automatic graphicator and separate the words, shall
we? All right, put it in there.
Here we go. Here we go. Just place it in there. And get this thing fixed. There they come. The words come out here, you see. Ho. Silver. High. There we are. Ho, silver, high. Makes no sense at all.
Well, I said it to the horse, and the horse just looked at me.
Uh-huh. Perhaps the words are just not in the right order.
Well, why would you say that?
Well, I'll show you, masked man.
All right. You see,
the first thing I noticed was that the sentence did not begin with a capital letter. Now, we know that all sentences begin with a capital letter.
Of course.
So it must be one of these other words, silver or high. Now, if one of those is the first word of the sentence, the other one could very probably be someone's name, because names also begin with capital letters.
Yeah.
Now, let's see. Whose name?
Well, maybe it's the horse, because the horse is supposed to go.
I've got it! The message is supposed to make the horse go, right? So the horse's name is probably in the message,
that's
you see.
Right. Sounds good to me. Yes,
yeah,
sir.
What's the horse's name? What's the horse's name? Rover? Spot?
No, it's something shiny, shiny.
Shiny. Silver yeah. is shiny. The yeah. horse's name is probably...
Silver.
Exactly.
Silver. Silver.
Silver.
Yes.
That means this word, high, is
yes.
probably the first word of the sentence. It's
uh-huh.
the only other capital letter.
Okay.
You see.
Yeah.
So, hi, ho, silver. Now, let's just add a little punctuation.
Yeah.
Okay, let's try this.
Hi, ho, silver.
Hi, ho, silver.
Hi, ho, silver.
Hi, ho, silver. No, that doesn't work. You wouldn't ask a horse a
no,
dumb
because,
question
see,
like
look,
that.
No, because, see, look, I'm in a hurry.
That's it.
Yeah.
That must be it. Yes. When you get on a horse, you're in a hurry.
So
you don't
far.
Ask him to go. You
no.
tell him. So get rid of that. Right. We'll just put an exclamation point there instead of the question mark.
Hi-ho, silver. Hi-ho, silver. Yeah, that sounds about right. Well, thank you, Mr. North. Now, what do I owe you?
Not a thing.
No, you must take something. Take this.
A silver bullet.
Yes, a silver bullet. Easy, big fellow. Easy, big fellow. Well, adios, amigo.
So long, and don't forget.
Forget what?
Hi-o, silver!
I'd like to get together with Fargo sometime when I'm out of town.
Gonna put my right shoe right on.
Right on.
My left shoe right on.
Right on.
Put the TV right on.
Right on.
Gonna put the kettle of tea right on. Gonna make a right on the corner of Main Street. Gonna be right on time for the track meet. Got all the answers right on the test I took. I left all my money right on top of that book. I'll go right on singing.
Right on.
Right on down to the store.
Right on.
Be right on till my mouth is sore.
Right on.
And I can't say right on right anymore.
Adventures of Letterman. Small talk. Today, we find our hero packing his trunk for a quick trip.
Now, let's see. I need my R and my V. Well, that takes care of all my letters.
Now I have that Letterman where I want him. All his rotten letters locked in a trunk.
Oh, my.
And with that, our evil villain takes his magic wand and changes the TR into J, turning the trunk into junk.
Now, my meddling fool, I shall fix you for good.
The Spellbinder takes his magic wand and changes the J into SHR, turning junk into shrunk. Oh, my goodness! Letterman has shrunk!
You were too big for your britches anyway.
Will our hero spend the rest of his life only 5 inches high? Will he only be able to use lowercase letters? Will he have to have his entire wardrobe altered? What can he do? Well, our hero may be small, but he still has power. Letterman flies up to the letters, faster than a rolling O, stronger than silent E, able to leap capital T in a single bound. It's a word. It's a plan. It's Letterman. He takes the SHR and flies away with it, leaving UNK. Unk.
UNK. Unk.
He flies back with H, making him the gorgeous hunk of Letterman that he was.
Uh-oh.
Here I come.
Help! Why don't you pick on someone your own size?
Take that.
Oh, no!
He bent my little... Oh, he bit my little wand.
Well, folks, it looks like the end of our villain. But is it? Tune in to the next amazing chapter and see.
Lester, how's your new club coming along?
Hey, beautiful lady. We just got a new member, and he's great. His name is Silent E.
Wait a minute. Silent E?
Yeah, we're going to use him to style in other clubs.
Well, what if he gets caught?
Silent E is cool, baby. He won't talk.
How can I find Tanzania on this? I can't even turn him miserable. Help!
Someone needs help. I shall respond, for I am not what you see before you, a mild-mannered house painter. Rather, I am... That truly splendid person. Spray man. With my trusty spray can, I am ever ready to come to the aid of those having trouble with words.
It's a walrus. It's a bathtub. It's Spray Man. You okay?
Of course. That was one of my better landings. Aha! I see your problem. This word says glob. Do your stuff, spray can. By adding an E at the end, it becomes globe.
Incredible, Spray Man. How can I ever thank you?
You might show me how to get home. I'm lost.
Jennifer of the Jungle.
We're hopelessly lost.
Yeah, now, don't give up hope.
All right, then, we're hopefully lost.
What was that?
A parakeet, maybe?
Sounded more like a boy soprano.
No, look, some lady on a string.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Jennifer of the Jungle.
The very girl we was looking for.
You? Me?
We have a telegram to deliver to you.
For me?
Yep.
Oh, you okay?
My, what kind of telegram? Yes, that's Paul.
Well, now, you've heard of singing telegrams, right?
Yes. Oh, you know, one of my relatives got one of those. Okay. Remember that, Paul? My rich uncle died and left me all his.
I remember that one, yeah. Well, we're kind of going beyond singing telegrams now. Yeah, the latest thing we got now is the singing and dancing telegrams.
Oh, that sounds. Did I get one of those?
Did you ever get one of those?
No!
Put it right there. Hold this. Get a load of this.
Oh, hey.
Hit it. You're going to love this.
Oh,
swinging on any vine, Jennifer of the Jungle.
Who brings a smile to every Nile crocodile, Jennifer of the Jungle.
Who turns December to June, who makes me sing in the rain.
Ask any chimp or baboon,
who would make Tarzan's rough Jane.
Miss Python's refuse to hiss,
Jennifer of the Jungle.
Who is the her who makes every lion purr,
Jennifer of the Jungle. Who makes the oyster rejoice, proudly to her do we point.
Who is Godzilla's first choice,
who brings such class.
Your jungle drums, that's the most. But who sent this telegram?
Well, let's
anyway?
See. It's signed, Happy Birthday, Paul. Do you know a Paul?
Paul! Well, meet Paul!
That's Paul!
That's Paul!
Paul,
isn't that
Wasn't
sweet?
That nice?
He sent it for my birthday, but he was a little late. Paul, you know, my birthday was 2 years ago.
You mean it's only 2 years late? Hey, we set a new record! Hey, talk about speedy delivery.
Yeah, gee, I wish Mr. McFeely was here to see us now.
Hey, listen, while you guys are in this neck of the jungle, why don't you just stay for dinner? We're going to have banana surprise.
Banana surprise?
Yeah, well, it'll be a surprise if I can get it to the table before Paul finishes it off.
Well, gee, we'd love to stay, but we still have a lot of work to do. We have a Lincoln's birthday telegram to deliver.
Oh, you don't happen
to know where Abe's living these days,
Abe,
do you?
Abe, well, I used to take taps
you know?
From him. That way, and then to the left.
Okay.
Oi. Joy.
If you were walking at night and saw a falling star drop into a jar right at your very feet, and if you saw in that star another jar with another star and another jar and another star, each inside of each, the question is, would you put the lid on the jar? Or would you send them far, far away to light up the sky?
Sam sit in the sun. See Sam sit in the sun, sipping soda. Everybody. Once again now, only this time, you say the words. Sensational!
Coming from Spider-Man, nobody knows who you are.
Here he is, true believers, your friendly neighborhood Spider-Man. Today, he meets that foe of fun and festivity, the birthday bandit.
Oh, it's beautiful.
It certainly is. I just know little Dickie will love it. Come on, I need some help in the kitchen.
A birthday. How nicely they have planned it. Just for me, the birthday bandit. I'll take these party hats and favors and this ice cream, all three flavors. I'll make off with this birthday cake. And I'll not forget to take these birthday presents, everyone. And now I'm off to have some fun.
Oh, no.
Only one person in the world is mean enough to steal a kid's birthday.
You mean
the birthday bandit.
Spider-Man, where are you?
Here's the late news from the CTW newsroom. It was an unhappy birthday for little Dickie Landon today. A mysterious bandit made off with his birthday, every present, party hat, and favor, and all the cake and ice cream. Police say only one person in the world is mean enough to steal a kid's birthday. The birthday bandit.
Meanwhile, the birthday bandit has found another victim.
Paper hats and toy balloons, Dixie cups and plastic spoons. There's absolutely no mistaking a birthday party in the making.
Later that day.
I see it's birthday number 8 that they intend to celebrate. I'll take each gift and decoration for my private recreation. But what is this? A giant cake. It's obviously just a fake. I'll bet this cake is here to hide that rotten Spider-Man inside. It's my mistake. It is a cake.
And so Spidey gets the birthday bandit and spends the rest of his day off in his birthday suit doing laundry.
Spider-Man, where are you coming from, Spider-Man? Nobody knows who you are. G-I-O-N, 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 say the end of new pollution. Think of all the fish making motion. Pollution means execution. Think of all the living plantations. Pollution will kill creation. G-I-O-N. Chun-chun-chun-chun. G-I-O-N. Chun-chun-chun-chun. Now we need participation. Let's stamp out pollution.
You mean goggles.
No, no, that's what someone does for a sore throat. Goggles with mouthwash.
You mean gargles.
No, that's what the water in the tub does. It gargles down the drain.
No, you mean gurgles.
No, gurgles are what we wear to look thinner. Frankly, my gurgle is killing me.
You mean girdle.
No. Oh, a girdle is a thing you cook flapjacks on and girdle cakes.
No, you mean griddle.
No, a griddle is a tricky question with a funny answer, like what has four eyes and sings through its nose. I know a lot of griddles.
No, you mean riddle.
No, that's what a worm does. It riddles off the hook.
You mean wriggle.
No, that's when you act silly and can't stop laughing. You have the wriggles.
No, you mean giggle.
Oh, well, for goodness sake, that's what I said. How do you like my new giggles?
Oh, they're terrific. I got myself a pair here.
Quiet hound. I don't bark or run around. I just lie here on the ground with my head upon this mound. No one knows where I can be found. If they knew, then they'd be bound to come and take me to the pound. That's why I don't dare make a sound.
May I help you?
Oh, I hope so. I've got to see the doctor. I'm in a lot of pain. A lot of pain.
Nurse, what's the commotion
doctor,
out here?
I don't know. This man's...
Doc, you got to help me. I'm Wally Sagittarian, you know, the place kicker for the armadillos. And I'm in pain,
well,
Doc.
The guy that kicks the extra point with no shoe off.
You got it. And that's how I stubbed my big toe.
Well, let's have
my
a
poor
look.
Little big toe. I'm in pain. Oh, Doc, easy.
Okay,
easy.
Okay. Oh, Wally, your toe looks all right. It's just a little bruised here.
I don't care how it looks. I'm in pain, don't you understand? Pain!
Well, what's the matter with you? Everybody's in a little pain once in a while. You're not the only one. Look at me.
Huh?
My back is killing me right now from being on my feet all day.
I should say, and my feet, honey, my feet tell me when it's gonna rain before the weatherman.
You're kidding. And I'm not the only one with pains, eh?
You're not the only one with pains.
Every track has a train. Every sink has a drain. Every cloud has some rain. And everyone has a pain. So what do you really gain? It makes no sense to complain. From Purple Mountain to the fruited plain, everyone has pain.
Every boat has a chain. Every bib has a stain.
Yeah, how are you?
Oh, okay. You busy?
Yeah.
What you doing?
Typing a letter.
Oh. Is it important?
Yes, it's a very important letter.
Oh. I thought maybe you would want to play a game of checkers or something like that.
Well, later, see, I gotta finish this letter first.
Oh. Sure, my speech, I'll be porting a letter.
Yes, this is a very important letter. There, that does it. This letter is complete.
Oh, could I read it?
Sure.
Oh, it's a C. It's very beautiful.
Yeah, guess I sure can turn out a beautiful letter if I put my mind to it.
You certainly could.
If I do.
Glasses, yo-yo, these glasses. And you, Lash, you say, to the queen. You got that?
Yeah.
All right, in case you don't got it, stop! You read the sign which says, to the queen. Have you got that?
No sweat.
Well,
hey.
You'd better get it right or we're going to run your fan mail through the shredder.
No, no,
that's wrong.
Three musketeers and a sailor, take 41.
Passion!
Gentlemen, for the queen.
Lash, it's not for the queen. Read the sign. It says, to the queen.
Yeah, okay. To the queen.
Very good. I knew you'd get it right. That's why you're a star. That's why you've made 11,000 appearances on Hollywood Squares.
Yeah!
Round!
Three musketeers and a sailor, take 42.
Passion!
Gentlemen, towards the queen.
Oh, what?
Cut!
Cut and all that implies, Lash.
Read the card.
If you don't want to read a get well card, yes.
Okay. To the queen.
Tell them, roll them.
I don't need this. Three musketeers and a sailor, take 43.
Action.
Okay. Gentlemen, at the queen.
Oh, that tear that you get yourself another monarch cat.
It was an honest impulse. We can fix it at the mix.
Flash, do you have any idea what you just did? And do you have any idea to whom you just did it?
Hey, to the queen.
To the queen!
Get it. Two. Together. Get it together.
You came to call. We really had a ball. The show is done. We hate to run. We're sorry, but that's
now, the last word.
Chicken.
Champ.
Gong.
Time.
Barber.
Rack-tack.
Jingle.
Hot.
Flower.
Fist. Prize.
Cast.
Cock-a-doodle-doo.
Forever.
That's a long time.
Yeah.
We here at Noggin hope you enjoyed this special presentation of The Electric Company. I don't know about you, but we flipped when we saw the silhouettes again. And this was just a little snippet. You can catch The Electric Company all the time on Noggin, and you can catch Noggin all the time. Noggin's a 24-hour commercial-free thinking network, on TV and online, made for kids and by kids. Plus, it's filled with retro stuff from when you were a kid, like Sesame Street from 1969. So if you want to get your Noggin now, go to Noggin.com and call your local cable or satellite company.